pregnancy and swelling both goes hand in hand. So many people ask me कि swelling का क्या issue होता है, doctor के पास कभी जाना है, that swelling is actually hurting me, bothering me, what's the issue? So let's understand few of the home remedies to reduce swelling in pregnancy. Before we get into that, understand once you should visit your doctor if there is a sudden swelling. So mild swelling here and there, like on your hands, on your feet, it's normal. If there's a sudden swelling, like कल तक कुछ नहीं था और suddenly आज सुबह जब भी आप उठे और by the end of the day you develop lot of swelling, you need to visit your doctor. If you want mild swelling and you are working, like full day is getting developed and by the end of the day you are having a mild swelling here and there, no need to go to doctor. You can just do bit of hot water fermentation, like garam pani mein thoda sa namak dal ke apne paon ke upar dal do, you will feel better about it. Second thing, you need to get your BP check. Agar aapka swelling bahut zyada badh raha hai, please see to it that your BP should be in control. It should not be that we are doing home remedies and there is some medical issue that is bothering you. So you need to nil that factor. In case any one of you is having bleeding, like vaginal bleeding or spotting kind of a thing, then you need to avoid these exercises. Second, if you've got too much pain around your pubic bone or around your private area or a lower abdominal line, too much pain that you cannot bear it, then you should be avoiding these exercises. And lastly, none of these exercises that we're showing to reduce swelling are meant to give you discomfort. If while doing any particular exercises you're feeling discomfort, you can discontinue doing those exercises. Currently for us, Sarita is one of my friend and student. She'll be showing us all the exercises. So I'll be inviting her and she'll be showing all the exercises. So for first exercise, Sarita is sitting over here with legs spread straight in front. So for all of you understand, being a pregnant lady, you just sit straight, legs are absolutely straight and toes are pointed towards you. So just moving of the toes of front and towards, front and towards. So continue doing this exercise for 10 counts. Why this particular exercise is important? Because swelling gets built up because of pressure at the ankle. So once you keep your ankle moving, you will feel far better. Next exercise, ankle rotations. Again, this is the exercise which helps you to feel mild stretch at the calf muscles and feel better at the ankle. So it will help you to improve blood circulation in that area and helps you feel better for your swelling. She's done one side, even opposite side you need to do. So this is opposite side, 2, 3, 4 and 5. We are showing you all the exercises for 5 repetitions. If you are comfortable, increase it to 10. If you are not comfortable, stop it at 5. It's absolutely your choice. Next exercise that actually helps a lot with respect to a swelling management is sitting in Vajrasana. So in Vajrasana, she is sitting with her feet absolutely. Can you just see, can you lift your hips up? So she is sitting with legs flat and heels up and she is sitting on the heels. There are so many pregnant girls who are not comfortable sitting in this particular position. So you can even sit with your toes down and on your heels. This will make sure that there is less pressure at your ankle and the feet area. And this will help you to get rid of swelling if it's there. If it's not there, still doing all these exercises will make sure you don't get swelling. So these exercises are helpful for both the things. So you sit in this posture at least for 5 deep breaths. Take a deep breath and exhale. In case you are sitting in the earlier posture that we have shown, in the same thing also you will be doing for the 5 breaths. Okay? And last one breath. Next exercise that is extremely helpful. For this, first you have to take a camel and cat position. A little back, yes. So she has taken a camel and cat position. Please understand, this particular position needs to be taken where chest and hands are in 90 degree angle. Her thighs and abdomen is forming a 90 degree angle. Never bothered about the hanging of the weight at your stomach that you are bound to feel. So because in currently this video we are talking about swelling in pregnancy, the next exercise that will actually help and make you feel very good at your calf and ankles are. So you straighten your knees and try and touch your heels on the floor. And hold it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and relax. Very good. Once again, straighten your knees, try and touch your heels. She is able to touch, But it's not compulsory for any one of you. If you can't touch it, don't touch your heels on the floor. Release. Once again, lift. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and release. Superb. So this particular exercise again, 5 times. If you're very, very comfortable with this exercise, the way Sarita is, the second part of this exercise also is very helpful to reduce swelling. It's basically you take the mountain pose and you will be doing moving of your legs. Just bit. She's able to lift her toe. If you can't lift your toe. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Release. Super. So personally, if you all can see, she's able to do both the ways. Because she's able to do both the ways of mountain walk kind of a thing. So I made her do both. You choose and take your decision. Please don't push your body beyond it, what it can do. Next exercise, which is leg raises. You need to lie down next to the wall where legs are raised on the wall. For all of you viewers, if you feel uncomfortable, if you're feeling out of breath, take a break, have a sip of water and then continue. So, folded your legs the way you fold it normally. Just folded it on the wall. What is very important is that legs are raised. Okay, so you take this particular position. Then slowly you straighten your legs. Yes, hold this particular position again for 5 to 10 breaths. Once you're done with those 10 breaths, just spread your legs. Yes, as per your comfort, you will spread your legs. Then again, hold for 5 breaths. Super. Then you need to do butterfly position. Yes, in butterfly position, both the feet are joined, knees are apart, and you hold that position again for 5 breaths. And lastly, feet are on the wall and legs are spread. See, this is very important. She is currently in a 9th month of pregnancy, so she need to keep the distance where stomach can fit in between both the legs. I don't want any pressure of thighs to be put on her stomach. So there is a distance that is taken so that her position is very comfortable. This helps blood circulation to be reversed so that she don't feel any kind of a pressure at the calf and at the ankle, and will help her to get rid of swelling. So gently turn on one side and you can sit. So for all the viewers, so these are the exercises that you can do. Apart from that, few of the dietary changes that you need to remember. If you have got swelling or if you have a tendency to get swelling, once you're medically checked, everything is okay, please have loads of water. You need to keep yourself hydrated. That will make sure you don't get swelling at all. Second thing, you need to be having your fruits regularly. At least one fruit should be vitamin C rich. Even that will make sure that you don't get swelling. Third thing that is 100% helpful, please reduce the salt intake. Salted chips, every salad that you have, you put a lot of salt on it. Every fruit that you have, every chaat that you have, you add a lot of salt from the top. It's not good. You need to reduce the salt intake in your day-to-day life. Fourth thing, you need to be moving. You cannot stand for a longer time. You cannot sit for a longer time. Like once it's 1 hour, 1.5 hours, just get up from your place, move a bit. At least once in 4 hours. So you all have got sofa at your place or at your workplace. You can get 2 chairs. On one chair you sit and you raise your, keep your both the legs in front on another chair, which is slightly raised. Or you've got an armrest on your sofa. So you sit on the sofa horizontally and keep your legs on the armrest. Even that will help you to get rid of swelling. And lastly, on an everyday basis, at least make sure that you do 20 to 30 minutes of exercises or walk. One of the things should be there, either you do exercises in the evening, walk in the morning, or exercises in the morning and walk in the evening. These are the things which will make sure that you don't develop much of the swelling throughout pregnancy. Thank you so much, all of you. Pregnancy does not mean pampering. Yes, but it definitely means care. Do care for yourself. We care for you. Keep watching my Dvija YouTube videos. Thank you so much and bye. Bagu the battery tana geli na madhur. Chalu hai.